Right, good morning. Weather horrendous. 40 mile an hour winds. Heavy rain. Don't think you put a milk bottle out in this, but I'm going to have a go at going fishing. So we're going to try Maythorne again, but we're going to go to the chocolate brown lake, as I call it. It's a smaller one, more of a pond than a lake, that's heavily stocked with silvers. Let's see how we go. Speak to you later. Bye. Right, good morning. So it's really windy, so I've managed to come to the far end of the lake that's a lot more discoloured. Anyone who watched the previous Maythorne video, I was on the natural lake, the water was too clear. It's not like that today. So we are fishing blue hydra, £3 line, £2 bottom, probably 4 foot deep. I've got a little midi. And I can't see the number of it because I haven't got many glasses on. It's the smallest float anyway, because we're fishing for silvers today on our top kit. So can we catch a pound roach on our top kit in winter? I've already had a little put in. I've got a couple of little roach and very small fish. So I'm feeding a little bit of corn for the bigger roach. I've got some dead reds for anything that swims. I've got my liquidised bread and dead red soup. I'm chucking little balls of that in, just a little pinch of that, and hopefully the breadcrumb will attach the bream, but it's creating a nice mesh as it like a mesh to its surface and then sinks quite quickly to the bottom and creates a lot of tiny particles along the bottom to keep the fish interested. And then we have Warburton's bread punch. So I've got a few change baits. Give me a bit of an option, but I'm on double maggot at the moment. Let's see how we go. I was kinder potting it, but change my mind, I'll check that off. It'd be lovely if we get a pound roach today, that'd be fantastic. This end of the lake, the more natural end, away from the cockpit platforms, is a little bit shallower than the rest of the lake. So I'm hoping the fish are still going to come into this area of the lake. But there's always a risk that they won't, but I've had to come here out the wind because it's blowing a hoolie. You might be able to just see on the footage. The wind blowing down the main part of the lake is howling, so I've come back into a bay. It's a bit shallower, but it's well out the wind. Then we've got dead reds again. No proper maggots, but on my top kit I can still throw them in. I'll throw a few bit further out. Because I'm fishing a long lash, I can experiment where I'm actually fishing. Almost fishing it a bit like a whip. the blue hydro. Oh, come off. The fish may be holding a little bit further out. So I didn't really want to fish a whip because there's carp in here, and you're bound to get a carp on as soon as you pull a whip out. Got on a number 8 back shot on there, so it's giving me that nice L position. So I'm going to keep a tight line to the number 8. It's fine for anything. Oh, lost another one. I'll have to just check that hook. So as long as I keep a tight line to that shot, it's fine. But if I let the shot sink, then the float sinks straight away. I don't know if you can see that on the footage. The float goes straight down, so it's forced me to keep a nice tight line, so I've got no slack. I'll hit a lot more bites and start to get some nice little roach. Little balls, little tiny balls going in. There's a lot of skimmers in here, so really hoping the breadcrumbs could settle on the bottom and encourage the skimmers to come in, even on this short line. One more section on a fish just a little bit further out. The fish are hanging back a bit to start with. Sharp on that one. Seven, eight roach and a perch, but they do seem to be struggling to come onto the top kit at the moment. So I've gone top kit plus one, and I've got a couple of more roach. Still only a little fish at the moment, a couple of 2 ounce fish is about the biggest I've had, but getting bite a chuck though, which is great for December. Trickling a little bit of bait in. fishing double maggot at the moment, trying to squeeze the really tiny roach and taking it. The float is shocking right down, so the tiniest indication you can see here. I'll give it another 15-20 minutes like this, and if you're not seeing any signs of a decent fish, then I'll probably go a couple more sections. Or I may even go out to 11 metres and just see if there's anything sitting towards the middle. First put in on a bit of corn and I've had a much better roach. Picking out the really small bits of corn. I'll start on top kit plus one. Just picking out a tiny bit of corn and just nicking it on. I've put like another 2 inches depth on, but a nice gradual slope. But this one rig, if I fished out to 11 metres, I could alter the float about another 6 inches. And, you know, because you fish the same rig right through the swim. There's no deep ledges or anything, no drop offs that I found anyway. definitely picking out the better roach. A tiny bit of corn on. Lovely that one, that's gradually getting bigger. That's 2.5 hours. Using my scissors and cut a piece of corn up. I can't find a small pea. Again, tiny little piece again. Took that bit of corn, lovely then. Be a nettable one, this one. We have a skimmer, a skim bob, some people call them. Hybrid, cross between a bream and a roach. It's a lovely fish, lovely condition. Look at that, beautiful. You wanted that bit of corn? Straight in. Again. Just that little bit further out. Throwing a few grains of corn creates a tiny bit of noise on the surface, and like a rat tat tat. Because I'm out of the main part of the lake, I've never fished at this end before. And maybe that's a bit of noise, which encourages the fish to come in close. Wait a bit longer for that one. I think it's a nice roach, but I think it might be a hybrid. Just a bit too big to lift up. Maybe 3 or 4 ounces. Good job I didn't try and lift it, because it what came out in the net. Come up to double figures, only been here, what, half an hour? It just shows you how well they're feeding even in the winter. Three reds now, 18 up, £2 6-inch trace. I've got three number 10s on the line. I've got a float, which is four number 12. So, very lightweight. Trying to catch on the drop, but it's not really working. I've got quite a long lash to my Dacron connector with blue hydro. Catch anything small. Really love to catch a pound roach plus. There's bream and roach perching here. There's carp, that's hence the reason I'm not fishing a whip. And blue hydra should help me get it out of a little puller, little puller connector in the end of my pole top kit. So see how we go. So three maggots seems to have done the trick. Roach are getting bigger. A bit finicky, but this is the biggest roach so far, which must be. Oh, six or eight ounce. So that is a lovely fish. That's a beauty. You just got to keep trickling the bait in, really. It's just nice to get bites when the temperature is this cold. Each little fish is like a block of ice.
Try three maggots again. That one on the drop, as soon as it got to the bottom, laying the rigging sideways, holding the tight line to the float, let the bait swing into the bait that I've just fed, see if we get a bite this time. Lift and drop. Try that again. Sometimes the three maggots, if there's lots of tiny fish there, then three maggots is a bit too big of a mouthful. We just want them nicer fish really to take the bait, don't we? We're going to try and pick out a better quality roach. They said that got that right on the drop then. As soon as it got to the bottom, something nailed it. Fortunately, I missed it. Oh, I've lost it. I think we're changing the hook. Well, hook change, bumped a few, so wasn't happy with the point of that hook. It was struggling to get through the maggots. I was hooking them on, so it's gone a little bit blunt. So I've put a G.20 on, fine wire. So slightly smaller. The lighter weight up. Proper bite. I've moved my backdrop further up as well, so I'm now about 6 inches away from the float. So I've still got the L, but it just seemed like the back shot. Oh, missed another one. Has been affected by the float was being affected far more than I wanted to, because the number 8 backdrop, probably a bit too big really at this range. Probably could drop down to a number 10. Got a single maggot on now, so I think I've got lots of small fish pulling at the single maggot. Fish are there, they're just quite shy. A very small piece of corn. I've probably had about 20 fish so far. The the hybrid and the roach. Yeah, probably 8 to 10 ounces are the two biggest ones I've had so far. Feels like a better fish. Feels roachy. Was it a bream? Oh, it's a hybrid. It's not quite the roach we're after, but it's a decent fish. It's a decent fish, it's a good hybrid. Look at that, beautiful. What a fish that is, absolutely gorgeous. Must be a pound, maybe a bit more. There's the mushed up bits of corn. Be selective with the bits of corn, get the tiny bits out. Encourage the should get right in a minute. Yeah. Mud on my pole. Get that off. lifting and dropping, trying to encourage the fish to take it. Got bread all at the end of my pole then. Little touch then. We have our first goose visitor today. We'll try and corn again. Just missed a bite. And the previous put in. I'm getting far less bites on the corn, but everyone seems either a better roach. They've had the two hybrid skimmers on there as well. Although I did get my best roach so far on triple maggot. Took a while, but the rain's coming down properly now. Definitely forecast a decent amount of rain today. I don't think I've done any videos yet without it being raining. We've sat under an umbrella, and every one so far. Although there is something quite atmospheric about sitting under a brolly with it raining and you're fishing. Oh, missed it. That was a fast bite. It's got really dark now. It's probably only about 11 o'clock, half 11. I started around about 10 today. Actually, I got here about half 9 today. Probably started about 20 past 10. So it's probably nearer 12 o'clock now. wish I'd bought some casters. Oh, it's a nice roach. It's going crazy. Let's net him. Got a bit loony. That was a fastball, the one I missed it on the previous putting, which snatched at the core. Hooked in the bottom of the mouth, so they're coming down for it. Nice fish anyway. 5 or 6 ounce. Again, a little ball of liquidised bread, a few maggots, dead reds, and then a couple of grains of corn. So really gentle on the feeding. But I'm hoping that crumb will, you know, encourage the bream to stay in position if they actually decide to turn up and have a go today. Because there's some lovely bream in here. A little lift and drop. Indication there, missed it. Should have waited. Oh, missed again. Hardly a good bite. Often the better fish in all the bites you're missing. You always like to think that. Oh, I do anyway. Of course, with a piece of corn, it could be a little fish pulling at the corn. Just sort of pecking at it. Oh, that's three on about. Three consecutive bites missed. See if you can let the necks might develop a bit. Check that bait, to make sure the point of the hook is still showing. So I had four bites on that put in. Just everyone, it's still showing, pretty good. Give it a little bit more feed, a few grains of corn. Liquidised bread and a few maggots. There's so many silvers in here, you're not really going to overfeed him as long as you're not going mad. Hello.
Hello.
We have visitors. Absolutely silent down still. I've just missed two or three bites on corn that's like snatching at it, really. Trying a couple of red maggots again. Oh, got a fish. Oh, it's come off. So much for my new hook. We're trying bread punch at the moment, got a 4mm piece on. Oh, straight away, little roach. He wanted that, didn't he? No messing around with that. As soon as it sunk to the bottom, I nailed it. Let's try that again. on again. That's two in two. He's going to make it three and three. Let's try a little ball of crumb. That fed just crumb, fed nothing else. Just a little ice cream, no corn or maggots on this one. That's good. Oh, three and three. Well, quite a small fish, but they're sucking it straight in at the moment. Mr. Goose is back. I think I'm going to feed him some bread. Maybe later. A little ball of liquidised bread. Four in four. That's like four fish in about 2 minutes. Little ball of crumb again. Mix some more up. And again. So lots of roach there. They're not eating the maggot. They're pecking, I think, at the corn, hence a missing bite. Put a little bit of bread punch on, and away we go. Five in five. Bit of a squeeze, it's dropping off. Flatten it a little bit. That'll fluff up as soon as it gets in the water. Bite already. Little fish, six in six. Is it? So we've got Mr. Goose herding goose on his own. As usual, I wonder where all his mates are. slightly bigger. Very gentle bites. I'm just laying on a little bit. That's a bit better. Straight in the net. Right, we'll come back to that. So they're feeding so well on the bread, red punch, I'm coming back onto the topcoat again. And see if we can get them, still hoping to get a pound roach close in. I've had a couple already. On the bushes, up the weed. Can always edit that out later. Oh, it's tangled properly. We're talking a bit. So I've changed to a size 18 hook, slightly wider gape, so the bread's staying on better, and I can swing the fish in a bit more confidently. I've been dropping a few off, so. I've got roach now, you know, 3 or 4 ounce. I could swing in on the bigger hook. Also, when I'm putting the bread punch on, it just looks a bit better. It's a bit, you know, 5mm bread, 6mm bread and that. Trying to pick up the beck of fish, distorting that pound roach, I haven't got one. Plenty of roach, but just no big ones. Lots of little ones. That's a better one. So I'll paint this a bit more positively now. It's a bream. As much as I like to catch it, I was really hoping for a decent sized roach. It's a nice fish though. Just quickly scored your job. Let's have a look at him. It's a bit bigger than the one we had before. A lovely fish. Pound and a half, maybe? It's in the net. Nice just on the top kit though. I've brought them a bit closer in. I'm fishing 6mm pieces of bread. A bit bigger. Hopefully that'll encourage bigger fish. Although I'm still getting them little roach on the, even on the 6mm bits. There's so many roach down there, they're pecking at it. It's such a big piece of bread. Tend you to let the bite develop a little bit so it doesn't strike it off. Oh, that was a better fish as well. There's some better fish there now. It took a while, but they're there. So I bumped that last one, it felt like quite a nice fish. Still lots of little roach there though. Luckily the bigger up, though, a bit more positive, is helping land more fish. Still getting roaches up now. It's every put in roach on the top kit, all on 5-6 mil thread punch. And if you think about the cost of this day, it's definitely fishing on a budget. My liquidised bread is 5 slices of bread, 5 medium slices, best of both, Ovis. Liquidised up into one tub makes about a pint. Because you're only feeding small amounts, it lasts for ages. I mean, I could have made 2 tubs up, but I only made 1 tub. One of those is 5 slices of bread. And then at the moment, I'm still on my first slice of Warburtons. 1 slice, I'm still on. I've already had probably 100 punches out of it. After 1 slice. The whole loaf's less than a pound. Oh, drop that one off. I've used some dead reds out the freezer, but they're not, you know, hardly used any. Not even quarter of a pint so far, but they're not really that interested in them. And then you got the tin of corn. And I've been taking most of that out, so I've only used 40 or 50 pieces. We're freezing that for next time. So the cost of the bait for this session, probably about a pound, if you're lucky, including the corn. Definitely fishing on a budget. And I've probably got, at the moment, I've probably got, not a massive weight, 10 to 12 pound of fish, I think. I've probably got 50, 60, 70 roach, 3 or 4 bream or hybrids, that one big perch. But they're loving this bread punch. I'm not on a 6 mil piece of bread, but bread's nearly as big as the fish. My little bread punch, if you've seen that, you can just keep doing it and then it piles up and then they drop out. It's a great way of doing it, it's a real quick way. I can't remember where I got them from now. Probably selling them everywhere, but I've had it for years. I still feel like I've got a whole run of them that stay in there so they don't dry out too quick. Take one out, give it a squeeze. Stick it on.
Still not the finder I'm after though. Nice fish nonetheless, but not a pound. One of the days I'll be able to fish without putting a brolly up. Half a bit easier for myself. Might do a couple of sessions over Christmas.
see how we go. I think I might come on here and bring some casters. We might have roach in here. Casters may pick out the better ones. Missed it by a mile. They're much slower in my old age. Well, it's probably a tiny fish pecking at the bread. The last few minutes now. He wanted to come and pinch my bread. Give me a little bit of Warburtons. There's some nice fish down there, some nice roach. And skimmers. Good skim bob. Hybrid. They seem to fight well, these hybrids. Still finding some decent roach. But as nice as that one is, the big ones are still being elusive. I'm trying to stop him from eating the liquidized bread. As I throw it in, he's going for it. Yeah. Yeah, I'm feeding him. That's a problem, I suppose. Yeah. Just don't want him ever eating the bait, pecking at my float. another decent fish on. It's another bream. Well, that's a nice bream. That must be approaching 2 pound. Absolutely beautiful. That was an even bigger piece of bread. Dad would be proud of that. He used to love fishing bread at Attenborough Gravels. Big bucket of mulchy bread. Catching big bream all day long. He used to love it. 40 years ago that was. Right, so that, I think, we'll call it a day. That bream has finished it for the day. So we've had 4 hours. Must have had 80 fish for about a pound worth of bait. Just fantastic. We'll have a quick look. I'm not checking them all out. Let's try and get them through. Trying to get through the rings. Oh, there's at least 80 fish there. You can quite see them. There's a good 80 fish. Half a dozen bream, hybrids, loads of roach, and that big perch, which is a real bonus. I don't know if you can see them there. Must be 15, I don't know, 15, 17 pound of fish. Lovely. Oh, great session. Thanks a lot. End of the session, we had about 4 hours, 70 or 80 silverfish, doing a 2 pound perch and bream up to 2 pound, roach up to 8 or 10 ounce, didn't get that pound fish after, but I think come back next time, bring casters, try fishing casters and see if you can get the better roach. Thanks for watching, like button and subscribe even better if you can, and I'll do some more videos soon. Thank you very much, bye.